Hello, be here, and as you can see, I'm camping. Thanks to conditions in the atmosphere, the weather is chilly tonight. Luckily, I've got this campfire to keep me warm. I'm also heating up some water to make a nice cup of hot cocoa. Heat is great for camping, but it's also essential for life on Earth. Gases in the atmosphere help to keep enough heat near Earth's surface to sustain life. As this heat moves through the atmosphere, it contributes to weather and climate. But where does this heat come from? And how exactly does heat move through the atmosphere, impacting weather and climate patterns? Today, we'll describe how three different mechanisms of heat transfer in the atmosphere impact weather and climate. We'll also learn more about the greenhouse effect and explain how it impacts Earth's temperature. Let's dive in! Before we can understand the movement of heat through the atmosphere, let's review some basic mechanisms of heat transfer. As I'm sipping hot chocolate at this campfire, there are three mechanisms of heat transfer happening right now. Heat transfer describes how heat is moving. Can you identify all three examples of heat transfer? What are they? Pause the video here and record your thoughts. You probably noticed the crackling fire, the hot chocolate in my hand, and the pot of hot water over the fire. The hot fire is warming my face, even though I'm not touching it. This is called radiation. It's the transfer of energy through space by electromagnetic waves. This mug of hot chocolate is warming my hands. I'm not directly touching the hot liquid, but the heat is transferred through the ceramic mug. This is conduction, heat moving through direct contact between materials. We can see the final method of heat transfer in the hot water over the stove. The bubbles and currents inside the pot? This is one example of convection. It's the transfer of heat by the movement of fluids due to temperature differences. These temperature differences are called a temperature gradient. So, in this picture, we can see three mechanisms of heat transfer: radiation, conduction, and convection. Radiation, conduction, and convection are also methods of heat movement that happen in our atmosphere. These mechanisms play a big role in weather and climate patterns. As we learn how, follow along in your guided lesson notes. Let's talk about radiation first. Remember, radiation is the transfer of heat through space by electromagnetic waves. Electromagnetic waves are waves of energy that travel through space at the speed of light. They include visible light, which we can see, as well as other types of waves we can't see, like radio waves, ultraviolet light, X-rays, and infrared light. These waves don't need a medium like air or water to travel. They can move through the vacuum of space. In the atmosphere, radiation refers to the transfer of energy from the sun to Earth through these electromagnetic waves. This is how the sun warms the Earth's surface without needing direct contact, which would be way too hot. Radiation describes heat moving through indirect contact, but conduction in the atmosphere occurs when heat is transferred through direct contact between the Earth's surface and the air molecules immediately above it, warming the lower layers of the atmosphere. As the heat energy transfers to the air molecules, these air molecules start to move faster and spread out. This brings us to convection. Pause the video here and predict. In which direction do these hot air molecules move in the atmosphere? The hot air is moving quickly and the molecules spread out. This makes it less dense, so it rises. Cool air has less energy and moves less. The molecules are closer together, so cold air is more dense and sinks. Convection in the atmosphere involves the movement of warm air rising and cool air sinking. This continuous movement creates convection currents that distribute heat throughout the atmosphere, influencing weather and climate. To help describe heat transfer in the atmosphere, let's put these three mechanisms of heat transfer all together. Radiation from solar energy heats the ground. Conduction happens as this hot ground heats air molecules near the surface. These hot air molecules act like a fluid and rise. As the air rises, it cools and sinks. This circular movement is called a convection current. Convection currents in the troposphere are responsible for many weather and climate patterns. Keeping the right balance of heat in the troposphere is essential for life. So how do we make sure that as heat moves, it stays in the troposphere and doesn't escape into space? To answer this question, we'll need some help from the greenhouse gases in the atmosphere. Earlier in this unit, we learned about greenhouse gases in the atmosphere. Greenhouse gases like water vapor, methane, and carbon dioxide act like a blanket, trapping heat and keeping the troposphere warm enough for life. This is called the greenhouse effect. Just like a greenhouse traps heat inside a glass building to keep plants warm, these gases trap heat in the troposphere to keep us warm. Some greenhouse effect is critical for life on Earth. The natural greenhouse effect keeps just enough heat in the troposphere, and the gases in the atmosphere are balanced to maintain the right temperature ranges. But here's where things get tricky. While the greenhouse effect is good, too much of it can lead to problems. Human activities can enhance this warming and throw off the balance. How do you think humans enhance the greenhouse effect? Pause the video here to record your predictions. Burning fossil fuels, cutting down trees to build new structures, agriculture, all of these things can release extra greenhouse gases into the atmosphere. Because these greenhouse gases trap heat, extra gases leads to more heat trapping. This causes rising temperatures in the troposphere. When the balance of the greenhouse effect is disturbed, it can lead to climate change. Climate change is not the same as changing seasons. Climate change refers to long-term shifts in average temperatures and weather patterns. For example, in 100 years, if the average temperature in the United States increased by 10 degrees Fahrenheit, that would be considered climate change. Our climate has changed before. Over the last 4.6 billion years, the Earth has experienced cycles of cold ice ages and hot peaks. Today's climate is somewhere in the middle. But just because climate has changed before doesn't mean it's not a big deal now. Climate impacts everyone. We would all need a new closet if our climate changes. Even bigger than that, climate change can cause droughts that hurt food production, can increase air and water pollution, and can decrease biodiversity in ecosystems like coral reefs. The mechanisms of radiation, convection, and conduction are interconnected and can create feedback loops that amplify climate change. You'll have a chance to explore some of these feedback loops in your lesson activities. Remember, learning about climate is the first step in finding solutions to these big problems. As we went through the lesson today, we learned how heat moves through the atmosphere to maintain climate and weather patterns. We also learned about the greenhouse effect, the essential trapping of heat in the troposphere. We want to make sure we keep that greenhouse effect in balance, because an increase in heat could mean big consequences. Now I'm going to get back to the heat from my campfire. Until next time, remember, Understanding how heat moves through our atmosphere is like holding the key to our planet's climate future. Every action we take can help shape a better world. Stay curious, keep exploring, and never underestimate the power you have to make a difference. I'll see you next time. Hey, hey.